Welcome to the Walt Disney Group's weekly dining review. We'll be talking about Ohana's at the Polynesian Village Resort, giving our opinions and what to expect when dining at Ohana's. First, you'll head through this beautiful lobby, and then you'll head up to the second floor either by elevator or by stairs and go check in at their podium. We recommend you check in 15 minutes earlier than your actual reservation, which is allowed. Ohana's is a very busy restaurant, so sometimes they run a little bit behind for your seating. So getting there early actually helps. The reservation podium will hand you a buzzer to let you know your seats are available and ready to be seated. While you're waiting for your reservation, there's plenty of seating outside of Ohana's and also at the Tambu Lounge. When you're called to be seated, you're going to walk by this beautiful smelling counter that has the awesome pineapple bread. First, sit down, they're going to bring you that pineapple bread that smells so good, and they're going to bring you the pog juice, which is pineapple juice, orange juice, and guava mixed together. Ohana's, everything's served family style, so you all share. This is an old picture from one of our previous vacations, and things have changed though. So here you get bacon, eggs, biscuits, Mickey waffles, the awesome potatoes, and large sausages. This is from our last trip. Things have changed a little bit. You still get the biscuits, you still get the Mickey waffles, they added Stitch waffles, eggs, the potatoes have changed shape and possibly a little bit of the flavor. The sausages are smaller, but you also get this ham with this awesome pineapple topping. So the breakfast is still good even though it changed. While you're enjoying your meal, characters will be coming around to sign autographs and take pictures with you. From our experience, it's never been rushed and they take their time, especially with the kids. Now that was a review of breakfast. This is the review of dinner at Ohana's. When you first walk in, you'll walk by the grill with all the meats they'll be serving tonight, and it smells awesome. To start you off, they bring these mini loaves of bread, which is really good. They have the standard drinks, of course, of everybody else. They have the fountain drinks, water, and other alcoholic beverages. I, for one, go for the Lapu Lapu, which is rum, pineapple juice, orange juice, Bacardi, and a sweet and sour mix, served in a pineapple, or you can just get it in a regular cup, depending on what you want to pay. Next, they'll bring out a salad, which even the kids will like because of the sweetness of it. At least that's why I think my kids like it. So they'll have lettuce, has this lily koi dressing, diced papaya, and mandarin oranges. Really good. Again, Ohana's is family style, so you all share. You get some mixed vegetables, some sticky wings, some noodles, and some pot stickers. And it's all you can eat. So when you run out, just ask for more. Remember that awesome smelling grill you walked by when you first came in Ohana's? Now it's time for them to bring you the meat. They're gonna bring you chicken, shrimp, and steak. All you can eat to your table. I do recommend saving some room for the ultimate dessert, in my opinion. They have a banana bread pudding topped with caramel sauce and a scoop of vanilla ice cream, which is very decadent and very addicting, and is also all you can eat, so order as much as you want. Thanks for joining us in our review and our experience in the Ohana restaurant. Next week, we will be reviewing 1900 Park Fair. Bye for now.